So if you've been watching this channel for a little while, you probably know that I'm a big fan of cheese, and I've actually been starting to make my own this year. I figure if people like beer and they brew their own beer, and if people like wine and they brew their own wine, why can't I make my own cheese? Milk is one of those things where it's kind of weird. It's a really weird byproduct that we eat. Like, it's animal juice. If you ever wondered how cheese is made, this is how it's made. That white stuff in milk is basically bits of fat proteins and regular proteins. They are suspended in a liquid. Usually it's pasteurized, meaning that it's boiled, so there's no pathogens in it. And the next thing they do to it is they homogenize it, which is basically where they take all those fat particles, mix it all up so it's evenly distributed throughout the milk. The thing is that breaks down those fat molecules. Good for milk, but bad for cheese. You want nice, robust, fatty globs in your milk, because all those globs, you're basically gonna separate that from your liquid, and those globs you pack together and dry out, and that's how you make cheese.
So we wanted to give you guys an update on what's going on with Studio 4, because it is coming together really nicely. So let me take you around and show you what they've done. Guillermo and the boys have been working hard, starting up here. They've brought in the sheetrock all the way in and buttoned in this window. There was a gap in between where the original skylight was and where the new skylights fit. So that's gonna look really nice when it's done. As you can see, these beams are in pretty bad shape. They need to be sanded, they're super dusty. So the guys are gonna go through, they're gonna get a rotary sander, they're gonna come all the way across here, making this nice and smooth, and then they're gonna make it pop with some beautiful color. We got rid of that old, horrible air conditioner that was about 30 years old and probably had some cancerous materials in it. It really makes the height of the unit pop out. Guillermo's done a really good job with this renovation so far. I think he's got about another 2.5 weeks to go. It's a big day. It's a big thing for us. I've dreamed about days with insulation and air conditioning.
What I'm going to do today is I'm going to take this gallon of milk and I'm going to make brie. Now, the process is basically the same for other types of cheese. Today, I have raw milk. This milk has not been pasteurized. It has not been homogenized. It is straight up raw milk from the cow. It's actually kind of hard to find. It cost me $17.50. But it tastes creamier and it's more rich and more robust. And if I'm gonna sit around and spend hours making my own cheese, why not go the extra mile, right? First things first, Carmichael, you wanna see what raw milk tastes like? Fat stuck to the top of it. If I shook this all up, you'd start getting butter. Taste it.
So good. I grew up having German milk with my grandparents. It was like so close to the texture and the taste of my German childhood.
The things you need to make cheese. 2 buckets of water, or bowls. Regular water for rinsing stuff off. Water with iodine to keep it sterile. The pot that I washed off, I'm gonna simply put the milk in. Now you have to bring the milk up to a specific temperature. In this case, 90 degrees Fahrenheit. That temperature activates the bacteria and the mold and promotes growth. All right, we're gonna leave that and let the milk warm up. Our milk is at the right temperature. We are going to put in the bacteria culture. Pure bacteria. Aromatic mesophilic. And you can buy this stuff from a bunch of different places online. Different cheeses use different bacterias. Now, put in the Penicillium camemberti. And this is a mold culture. And this is what's going to grow that white mold. Stir it in, nice and evenly distributed through the milk. Let it now sit for 15 minutes.
There's a lot of new players in the market for subscription digital services, and we've gotten a few offers to pitch things. So I'm gonna take you guys through that process of what's required when you're pitching a new show to a new client. Every great idea can be boiled down to 2 things. A great name and a 1-sentence description of everything you need to know. I came up with this idea called Country Ops. What does that mean? Well, it's a show about Corridor teaming up with the most experienced special operations veterans in the world to test their field skills in an all-for-fun, redneck-type game scenario. This simple description and title is what we would call an elevator pitch. It's called an elevator pitch because you gotta be able to tell it to somebody that you don't know in an elevator, but they don't understand what you're talking about, You blew it, kid. After you go through your description, you want to tell the reader a little bit more about what they're getting themselves into. On my scenarios page, I list out game type scenarios that give a little bit more context to what each episode would be like. Demolition derbies, ATV football, lawnmower racing. What's not to love? Even more important than what you write in a pitch document is what you show the viewer. So you got to include things in there that are simple and easily convey your message. Next, I move on to my format page, where I convey how the show is presented to the audience. Now, when someone's going out and spending a bunch of money on a show, they want to make sure that eyeballs end up on that project. They aren't able to go and to talk to everybody and get to know everybody, so you got to show them numbers. So here, for example, I've shown what our audience demographics are, what our geographical demographics are, what we're known for online, and what kind of connections we have that can help get this series done. At the end of the day, everything you do boils down to trust and credibility. And so our reach page just helps emphasize that, in fact, we do know what we're doing, and we've done this before. Lastly, you want to hit them with a little zinger that calls back to the title of the show. Here, I used our phrase, "See you in country." This gives them a memorable way on how they're gonna sell your great idea. When it's all said and done, don't be afraid and let your idea fly into the world.
No, no, my papers.
No. Good cheese takes a long time. I wanted to make Gruyère because that's it's a cheese used in fondue, and I really like fondue. It's kind of expensive too. Like, I'll just look up how to make it. It takes about a year. So now we're going to put in the rennet. And rennet is an enzyme. It's going to cause the curd to separate from the whey. I'm going to take one of these rennet pills, basically, just a capsule, dissolve it in some water. Now the thing is, you can't use tap water for that because tap water has chlorine. And chlorine will kill your bacteria cultures. And it's the same thing with salt. Salt usually has iodine in it. And at the end, we're going to salt the outside of the cheese to keep other molds from growing. But if you use salt with iodine, it can also kill all the bacteria. Stir. Give it a little shake. So this is going to now start reacting with the milk. Like, for example, if you take your blood, you have blood cells, but your blood cells are suspended in your blood plasma. So we're effectively separating the blood cells from the blood plasma. You take those blood cells and pack them into a little cylinder where they turn into cheese. After just turning it over in the mold for a couple hours and letting the liquid drain out, take the solidified block of milk fat now. I'll put salt on the outside and then put it in the fridge. And that's it. That's the extent of work. That's all it takes to make cheese. You grab your milk, mix your bacteria, your mold, the rennet to make it solidify, and you walk away more or less. This is the whole putting in a mold thing, but it's really not a big deal. Like, making cheese is really, really easy. I was surprised at how easy it was. It just takes time. Yeah, that's it. I guess we'll have another cheese party in a couple weeks.